I thank the gentleman for yielding. The majority wants you to think we're here today to help seniors. And this bill will help some seniors, and I intend to vote for it. But seniors shouldn't sleep well tonight, for they're facing massive cuts in Medicare benefits and pending health legislation proposed by the Democrats and the President. And that's what I want to talk about today. The reality is, the majority's health care bill will slash Medicare Advantage benefits for millions of seniors, and the administration is abusing its regulatory powers to keep that fact from seniors. This week, we learned that the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services has initiated an investigation into at least one provider of Medicare Advantage health care plans for accurately informing its enrollees that the Medicare cuts proposed in pending health care legislation could alter their benefits. CMS has since banned all Medicare Advantage health plans from providing similar information to beneficiaries. And let me just read to you the phrase that was communicated, and I quote, "If the proposed funding cut levels become law, millions of seniors and disabled individuals could lose many of the important benefits and services that make Medicare Advantage health plans so valuable," end quote. Frankly, this is government intimidation, pure and simple. Seniors know the President's Medicare cuts will impact their benefits. The Congressional Budget Office has confirmed these cuts could negatively impact Medicare benefits and increase seniors' costs. But when health care plans try to share that information with their enrollees, the administration slaps a gag order on them. It is an abuse of power, plain and simple. So while the government is intimidating Medicare health care plans, shockingly, no such pressure has been applied to those supportive of the President's Medicare cuts. AARP, which boasts the largest Medicare Advantage plan, for example, has directly communicated with its members via email, a website, and letters. However, their pro-Medicare cut stance has apparently received no scrutiny from the administration. CMS's selective use of its regulatory authority threatens the integrity of the agency and our democracy. And in fact, CMS's unprecedented action is in direct conflict with its own guidance issued during the Clinton administration. The then director of what was called HCPHA at that time, Center for Health Plans and Providers, instructed health plans in 1997, and I'm quoting, "Prohibiting such information would violate basic freedom of speech and other constitutional rights of the Medicare beneficiary as a citizen. As long as member materials that discuss the rights and responsibilities of the member and the HMO with regard to HMO membership are not misrepresented in the context of this article, we see no reason for prohibiting the distribution of information," end quote. This policy reversal by CMS is also at odds with Supreme Court decisions in the area. We need to get to the bottom of this, and we need to make sure all Americans, and especially seniors, know the facts about what the President and the Congressional Democrats' health care bill will mean for them. I yield back the balance of my time.
Someone yields back the balance of his time.